Manny Koshbin is a real estate mogul who is most known for his extensive supercar collection that has garnered him a massive audience on YouTube. From Bugattis and McLarens to Rolls Royces and Koenigseggs, Manny has them all. His cars often change as he constantly sells and buys the latest cars. But one thing that doesn't change is the growth of the value of his car collection. So, how much money does Manny Koshbin actually make to afford this many collectible cars? Well, starting off with his income sources, though he does make money from real estate, YouTube, and his supercars appreciating, most of his income is from real estate, so that's where we'll mainly focus on in this video. As for real estate, he has a $250 million real estate portfolio, including both residential and commercial properties. To estimate his revenue from this vast portfolio, we will use cap rates. A property's cap rate is the ratio between its net operating income and its purchase price. Now, cap rate doesn't include debt repayment or appreciation. It simply tells you what percentage you would profit every single year if you were to own the property outright. For instance, if you are looking at buying a $100,000 house to rent out and has a cap rate of 7%, this means that you will profit roughly $7,000 every year after accounting for vacancy, property taxes, insurance, maintenance, and so on and so forth. Cap rate accounts for everything except for appreciation and financing. Manny Koshbin lives in Orange County, California, where the median cap rate for apartment buildings is 4.15%, which is actually one of the lowest cap rates in California. But just because Manny lives there doesn't mean all of his properties are there as well. He has properties in many Californian cities and even a few properties in neighboring states. Averaging out the median cap rates of each county given in this list, we get an average cap rate of 5.42% for his apartment buildings. Looking at his office buildings, the average cap rate for suburban and urban office buildings across North America is 7.29%. And finally, as for residential properties, these properties generally have some of the highest cap rates. However, there's not much information about median residential property cap rates, as cap rate is generally a calculation you only use for commercial properties. But considering that most of Manny's properties are apartment buildings or office buildings anyways, we'll just assume that his residential property cap rates are also quite similar. If anything, they'll be higher than the commercial cap rates. Averaging out the cap rates for the apartment buildings and the office buildings, we get an overall cap rate of 6.355%, but to estimate conservatively, we'll call it 6%. With $250 million in real estate, this would come out to $15 million per year. But we know that he doesn't own all of these properties outright, so he doesn't actually get to directly keep all of this money. In fact, he likely has over $100 million in debt, as his net worth is only $50 million, which is of course not small by any means, but only a fifth of the valuation of his real estate portfolio. But this isn't actually a bad thing, as this allows Manny to pay off his properties and gain net worth without being taxed. And on top of that, he gets plenty of tax write-offs from carrying that much debt. So really, the only downside of having debt on real estate is the interest. This can also be used as a tax write-off to a certain amount, but commercial properties do have much higher interest rates compared to residential properties. So interest is definitely a bigger deal when looking at commercial properties. The average interest rate for commercial properties is 5-7%, so we'll say 6% on average. And as for how much Manny borrowed, when he bought these properties, he would have had to put down at least 15-35%. I don't think he's looking to over-leverage, so I'd say he put down at least 25%, which comes out to $62.5 million down. Now, you may be wondering, how would Manny be able to put down $62.5 million when his net worth is $50 million? Well, the properties were likely much less expensive when he actually bought them, so he probably doesn't have as much debt as this calculation would suggest. But we'll stick with it to keep it conservative. Looking at a principal paydown chart for $187.5 million in loans, the interest paid per month ranges between $5,500 and $937,000. As you guys probably already know, this is because a smaller and smaller portion of your payment goes towards interest each month. Over 30 years, the average interest payment per month would be $471,000, or about $5.66 million per year. So his net profit per year from real estate would be $9.33 million. But that's just principal paydown and cash flow. We still have appreciation, and California has some of the best appreciation rates in the entire country. Over the past 20 years, California has seen average annual appreciation of 4.99%. Even assuming 4%, this would bring in another $10 million in net worth gain from real estate. So Manny makes a minimum of about $20 million per year from real estate. But he likely has higher cap rates, upwards of 10%, and likely doesn't pay nearly as much in interest every month, as the price he paid for his properties are likely tens of millions lower than what they are worth today. With a 10% cap rate, $150 million purchase price, and appreciation of 5%, Manny could be making upwards of $34 million per year just from real estate alone. We'll estimate on the lower side and call it $25 million. Moving on to his YouTube income, Manny has quickly grown on YouTube, pulling in 4.334 million views this past month. But his videos are mostly for entertainment, as most people watching his channel are watching to see him mess around with supercars as opposed to actually learn about real estate. So his CPM is likely on the lower side at $2 to $4 per thousand views. This would actually come out to $8,000 to $16,000 per month, but this pales in comparison to his real estate income. And he is selling a few courses, but again, given the demographic of his viewers, it's likely that not many people actually buy his courses. Now, this isn't to say he doesn't make money from his courses, as I'm sure he makes tens of thousands from them every month. But again, this is not much compared to $25 million a year. As for appreciating cars, he has had a few outstanding flips, profiting millions from single sales. But these are far and few between. So if anything, his YouTube ad revenue, course sales, and other small income sources would add up to $5 million per year. As a result, Manny Coachman's yearly income is roughly $25 to $30 million. And I think we'd all agree that this is a
great success!
Anyways, if you're interested in how Manny is able to pour so much into cars, make sure to check out my video about that, and consider subscribing to see more questions logically answered. But until then, I'm Hari, and I'll see you guys on the next one.